The following program is appropriate for all ages and sensory friendly.
3, 2, 1. From Chicago, this is the Autism Channel World News with Roger Badish.
Thanks for joining us on the Autism Channel World News. We begin our Friday with a piece of conventional wisdom, the idea that the autism spectrum is an almost exclusive province of the male population. But as we so often discover down the line, conventional wisdom is not quite as wise as we think. That's our topic for today as we zero in on the growing study of a growing spectrum, one being led by our neighbors to the north. It's been thought that males on the autism spectrum outnumber their female counterparts by as much as a 4-to-1 ratio. Researchers are finding that due to gender biases in previous studies and differences in how symptoms manifest themselves, there may be almost as many females on the autism spectrum as there are males. Kevin Stoddard is the director of Toronto's Redpath Center, an autism support center offering therapy, counseling, and life coaching for people on the spectrum. In a long-form interview with Canada's national newspaper, The Globe and Mail, Dr. Stoddard detailed the growth of his clientele since opening 5 years ago. It's a base that's grown in diversity as well as size. Of the nearly 600 patients he and his center treat, nearly 40% are female, twice as many as his initial base 5 years ago. So why the disparity? Well, Dr. Stoddard believes that girls are taught at an early age to meet social expectations, and that conventional special interests, particularly playing with dolls, can't prepare them for social scripts. By knowing through rote memorization how to navigate social situations, autism is thus less evident in girls than in boys, whose special interests don't prepare them for interactions and lead to more evident symptoms. Other researchers believe there's more to the autism gender gap than simply learning the social rules early, and that this gap goes beyond autism and through studies involving the brain. According to Dr. Jillian Einstein of the University of Toronto, the field of brain research suffers from a paucity of female brains to study. The deficit is twofold. There are more male brains that have been donated to science, and female animal models are more difficult to study and more expensive to procure. Ironically, Dr. Einstein notes the hormonal irregularities that make female brains avoided in the lab are precisely why female brains demand further research. As a result, it is not only autism that is less understood and thus underdiagnosed in women. Research concerning dementia, schizophrenia, and multiple sclerosis in women also lags behind their male counterparts. With the problem identified, what is being done to solve it? Lynn Poslins of Toronto's mental health community has launched the Women's Brain Health Initiative. Citing that women are twice as susceptible to brain disease as men as they age, the initiative is raising funds to increase brain research on women as it completes its first year of operation. The cause is also receiving funding from Canada's federal government through the Institute of Gender and Health. It's hoped that these research grants will expand the work being done to bring about a fuller understanding of the human brain now, whether male or female. Finally, we wrap up another week in autism news and our Friday feature on women and autism with another group of women raising money for autism. In suburban Atlanta, Izzy Maternity raised funds for the Marcus Autism Center with a raffle and fashion show. 19 models, all of whom were devoted Izzy Maternity customers, modeled outfits from a number of brands. The Marcus Autism Center serves Metro Atlanta and the entire southeastern U.S. with autism diagnosis, treatment, and counseling offerings. Marcus is committed to leading the way in developing an autism diagnosis that can come as early in a child's life as possible. And that's the Autism Channel World News for Friday, December 20th, 2013. I'll be on vacation through the holidays, so I'll join you again after the new year. In the meantime, our news desk will remain open to bring you autism news and views from around the world. I'm Roger Badish. We really thank you for watching. And on behalf of the entire Autism Channel crew, happy holidays, especially from our Chicago Bureau.
Join us again tomorrow for the Autism Channel World News with Roger Badish. I'm Mary Beth Marsden.
The Autism Channel needs your help. We're setting a goal of reaching as many of the 500 million people touched by autism on this planet. Please visit our website. Click to help us reach the world.